The time for pussyfooting is through. The US and NATO are at war with Pakistan. Or, at least this is what Pakistan's lawmakers appear to be saying. The Standing Committee on Defense has taken up the issue of civilian deaths by US drones. It has called on the government to secure compensation from the North Atlantic Alliance. In addition, the committee is also requesting a detailed overview of the entire American drone program that stretches back as far as 2004 under the then Musharraf regime and that is also spanned across the two subsequent civilian regimes. We wholeheartedly support this move, and we do so while being mindful of the fact that there is no NATO drone program targeting the country. This is but a technicality of sorts, meaning that the latter, for the majority duration of this US-sanctioned warfare by remote control, was the multilateral security presence in neighboring Afghanistan, from where American drones were launched. And given that NATO has at the core of its charter the principle of collective responsibility, it seems only proper that it coughs up. Moreover, the multilateral security force has a mechanism for this end. It's just that governments have to do the asking. There might be a lesson there for the Islamic Military Alliance. The question of why Pakistan can't simply approach the US for compensation is slightly tricky, given that Washington only provides this to those nations with whom it officially at war, like Afghanistan and Iraq. Except that this isn't strictly true. Under the Obama administration, the US did pay out condolence cash to the families of an American and Italian aid worker, respectively. The two were killed in a botched US attempt last year to rescue them from the clutches of Al-Qaeda, which was said to be holding them hostage in Pakistan's tribal badlands. Washington is at war with the terror group, as well as others, as is Islamabad. And it is the US that is bombing their hideouts. So why should the families of local civilians not also receive blood money? Apart, of course, from the obvious truth that white lives matter. Pakistan made its first payout to civilian victims of drones back in 2011 in North Waziristan, in yet another indication of the tacit understanding between the state apparatus and the US over the drone program. In fact, it is only right that the Pakistani state accepts its role in consenting to the latter. Indeed, civilians are said to hold both the Washington and Islamabad responsible for threats to their security. This is to say nothing of the whether or not it is Pakistan that provides the majority of actionable intelligence. We hope that the government takes this call seriously. The time for backroom agreements is through. Pakistanis have spent the last year demanding transparency as well as accountability for the corrupt. This extends beyond investigating our leaders over ill-gotten assets. It also must include justice for the killing of innocent lives. We hope the Americans and NATO are watching and listening, because we will not stop raising our voice until this deal is done.